Dow's over, cause Revive is alive. It's about that time. It's Meet Your Girl POC. Tune in, let's go.
Hey y'all, Lauren Westerman here with Classic Events by Lauren. Check us out on Instagram, Classic Events by Lauren, or our website, www.classiceventsbylauren.com, for all your wedding and event planning needs. Now don't forget, tune in, Revive Radio.
You are listening to Revive Radio. The views and opinions expressed on Revive Radio does not necessarily reflect ownership, management, and advertisers of Revive Radio.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
You already know what time it is. Reviveisalive.com. Once again, reviveisalive.com. Tune in. Revive is alive. Welcome to Revive. It's about that time. Welcome to Revive. It's about that time. All I need is one mic. You know what time it is. Open up your ears. You know what time it is. Open up your mind. It's about that time. About that time. It's your girl POC. Hey. It's your girl POC.
The money turned into a monster. The money turned into a monster. The money turned into a monster. The money turned my noodles into pasta. The money turned tuna into lobster. They wanna do me.
You know, rocking with these fast.
I put my jewelry on his feet. 100 thousand, I used to do that every week. Never sleep, it's funny how it never speak. You see a foreign in my city, that was me. 4 a.m., I'm on the north side of Philly. Riding around like these haters don't wanna kill me. It's a shame how they hate on me. You gotta feel me. I started out with a dollar and got a million. I like, do it for the ground. Do it for the ground. She don't wanna bust it. I say, do it for them bands, yo. I say, do it for them bands. Fuck with that bro. You should do it for your man. Lately, I've been on the low with a hoe that you probably know. Took it to the crib and met mama right at the door. Mama started smiling like, mama, I gotta go. I done took so many trophies to mama. My mama know I'm son of a real nigga. I get that money, pay them bills, nigga. My mama tell me you a real nigga. And I be hanging with them real killers.
The assassins in the building, let's go. Turn your radios up. It's Tuesday, so you already know we got a jam-packed show for you guys, man. Each and every Tuesday, catch my guys, the assassin in the building. DJ D ready, let's get it. I'll explain, let's go.
The money tell me noodles in a pasta. The money tell me tuna in a lobster. They wanna do me, I'ma do it like a monster. Whoa. I put my jewelry on his feet. 100 thousand, I used to do that every week. Never sleep, it's funny how it never speak. You see a foreign in my city, that was me. Whoa. That was us, never sweet. We went to war, niggas riding down the street. Popping that pistol, they talking and never did. Dropping the nickel, I tell him we'll ever see. I've been sitting on that money like a chair. I've been getting to that money all year.
Slide on a pimp gang with my pinky ring. Lot of gang, lot of bitch in the icy chain. While you claim that you rich, that's a false claim. I be straight to the whip, no baggage claim. Whole lot of styles, can't even pronounce the name. You ain't got no style, see you on my Instagram. I be rocking it like it's fresh out the pen. Only when I'm taking pics, I'm the middleman. Walk talking like a boss, I just lift a hand. 3 million cash, call me Rain Man. Money like a shower, that's my rain dance. And we all in black, like it's gang, 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 gang. Say the wrong words, you be hangman. Why me stick to your like a spray tan? Mister, what kind of car you in? In the city, love my name. Gotta say, taste, she can get a taste. Taste, she can get a taste. Taste, what it say? It's all the same, like Mary Kate. Taste, she can get a taste. Taste, let you get a taste. Taste.
Jackson. D letter Y radio.
Yeah, that's cool, but he ain't like me. Fight me, check like check Nike. Me not icy, that's unlikely. And she gon' sh** me like a Pisces. Chains on the neck for the whole team. And I feel like Gucci with the ice cream. And my bitch want the Fenty, not the Maybelline. I'm the black JB, the way these bitch green. Make the bitch green.
We just getting started, man. Let's go.
Like my AE. Say, yeah, that I mean. She can get a taste. She can get a taste. What a nigga say? It's all the same like Mary Kate. She can get a taste. Let you get a taste. Yeah, that's cool.
G-Wagon, all the housewives pulling up. I got a lot of toys. 720S pumping Fallout Boy. You was talking shit in the beginning. I was feeling unforgiving. I know I pissed you off to see me winning. See the heat glue in my mouth and I be grinning. 100 bands in my pocket, it's on me. 100 deep when I roll like the army. Get more bottles, these bottles are lonely. It's a moment when I show up, God, I'm saying wow. 100 bands in my pocket, it's on me. Yeah, your grandma more probably know yeah. me. Get more bottles, these bottles are lonely. It's a moment when I show up, God, I'm saying wow. Everywhere I go, catch me on the block like a Mutombo. Wow. 750 Lambo in the Utah snow. Trunk in the front like Dumbo. Yeah. Cut the roof off like a nip tuck. Pull up to the house with some big pics. Turn the kitchen counter to a strip club. Me and Dre came for the. When I got guap, all of y'all disappeared. Before I dropped Sony, none of y'all really care. Now they always say congratulations to the kid. And this is not a 40, but I'm pouring
DJ,
out
of ready.
You serve a lot, but I got more now. Made another hit, cause I got more now. Always going for it, never pump fourth
down. Last call, in the building, hell, man, each and every Tuesday. Revivalsalive.com. Tell a friend to tell a friend, you gotta get up anyway. So why not get up with me, your girl, POC? Hey.
100 bands in my pocket, it's on me. Your grandma will probably know me. Get more bottles, these bottles are lonely. It's a moment when I show up, God, I'm saying wow.
No masterpiece. Hey. 10 bad, then they after me. Bam. 1 bad, look like a masterpiece. Looking for a dunk like an athlete. Big drip, what you call it?
Big drip.
Ice chain, peeled water.
Ice.
You got the cab, but can't afford them.
Cash.
You got the bad, but can't afford them. Give me the beat, I ride it like a jet ski.
Hey.
Some of the bad, they harassing me.
Bam.
They like me cause I rap and be with the athletes. Stop asking me, I know they mad at me.
Nah.
Hop in the coupe, then I slide like it's Vaseline. West Coast 6-4, jump like a trampoline. Take a brick out, put it on the triple beam. I'm not from Canada, but I see a lot of teams. Dismantle up, I know how to handle it.
Yeah, yeah, like candle up, make you put a banner up.
Toss a 50 up, make them tie the club up.
Took
your bitch out the game, I had to sub up.
Swap.
No masterpiece.
Hey.
10 bad, then they after me.
Bam.
1 bad, look like a masterpiece. Looking for a dunk like an athlete. Big drip, what you call it?
Big drip.
Ice chain, peeled water.
Ice.
You got the cab, but can't afford it.
Hurt cash.
You got the bad.
I'm in the dark, throwing 20 past 8. I'm in the dark, it's a movie score Scorsese. I'm in the dark, that's how life been lately. Trying to make a baby. I'm in the dark like you paid me. I need my hunters dark blue like the Yankees. Loaded, losing my focus. Need a bitch in the Benz, not a Ford Focus. I'm in the dark, I don't trust you, I'm toting. YG on board, we already know it. My life dark. The Lamborghini red, but it's dark. I drive mines in the dark, you leave it parked. Trust issues, I done had it since the start. I'm in the field with piranhas and the sharks. I get a lot of love, but it's dark. The freaks come out at night. The freaks come out at night. When it's dark, I'm in the dark going brazy. I'm in the dark throwing 20 past 8. I'm in
Alex
the dark,
Lane, let's go.
Scorsese. I'm in the dark, that's how life been lately.
Dynamic duo, let's get it.
Dark.
Finish your breakfast, man. Let's get to You gotta be there by 9. You got about 10 minutes to get there. We gonna get you there, man. Let's go. Get this morning mix, man, each and every morning.
Bills though. I'm just a 7-0 savage, no mysteries. Hot chicks on a stick, rotisserie. Put some season on them, cook them up, and leave them right there, never look them up. Hater, I know I'm in God's favor. I can tell by what I paid for this Aether. A good green gasoline Cali. Down south, need a Cali plug. NORCALIKING. Up BAYI. Grind, then shine. Then I like trees like Christmas time.
I got the zippers on deck. Pull up like FedEx, baby, won't drink. I got the rim in your deck. Pull up like FedEx, won't problems. Whole city's on deck. Pull up like FedEx, wanna slap her?
Act when they got money, now you done switched up on me. Now you wanna say what's up to me. Okay, so now you wanna make love to me. Girl, if you don't get the from me, I know you thought we had something special, but you don't mean nothing to me. Girl, I'm sorry you not the one for me. Just be honest, girl, what you want from me? This ain't nothing new, keep it so 100. I can't let none of these get one up on me. I go back, I tell you, you better run from me. Give hope to my niggas. This love money. Adios to the just can't get a hug from me. I'm high on life, that's what it does for me. My numbers going up, I feel a buzz coming. Young, your friends bad too, then come with you. And we like what they on, we don't like gold diggers. Girl, if you don't get the from me, I know you thought we had something.
Yo, Bryson Tiller changed the game of music, man. Bryson Tiller created something called Trap Soul. Like, that's a genre of music that not many people can tap into. You know what I'm saying? Like, when you think about Bryson Tiller, you really can hear how he separated himself, you know what I'm saying, how he created his own wave, and then also how he just, you know, made a way for people who really can't sing but want to rap too, you know what I'm saying, but got that little squeaky voice when you put a little auto-tune behind it.
Yeah.
Does it sound like auto-tune, or is this him? Just him flat out?
I think he can sing. I was going to say that because I seen a while ago.
This is singing to you guys.
I think he can sing because he did a Grammy performance a while ago with Rihanna when they did that song, and he was actually killing it.
Like, did you think he can sing?
He was actually in tune. I think he can sing.
That's what R&B is. That's exactly why R&B is dead right
now. No.
Yes.
That's just
because
like.
Because if you go tell me Bryson Tiller can sing, then that means he's in the R&B category, right?
What's his category? Trap soul?
Trap soul. Somebody who can't sing, can't rap, but you put it together with a little auto-tune.
Now, I just think what he does on the record is like chilling, but he can sing. Like, a lot of people didn't think T-Pain can sing, but T-Pain can sing.
Exactly my point. That's what I was going to say.
Okay, that was a good one. But T-Pain can't sing without the auto-tune.
He can. See, y'all, you ain't checked the vids with him singing without auto-tune.
He can sing without auto-tune. I'm just saying, like, when I think about, you know what I'm saying, like, male R&B singers, I'm thinking about a Tyrese.
Yeah,
I'm thinking about a Genuine.
Yeah,
I'm thinking about even a Jacquees. Jacquees can actually sing.
He can. T-Pain
can blow.
All right. I think people get the misconception that auto-tune makes you able to sing. You gotta still be able to be on key with auto-tune. That's real shit. Like,
because you got Lil Duval. He out here living his best life off the auto-tune. But, I mean, making banger track off the auto-tune. Black Men Can't Cheat got some auto-tune in it.
Yeah,
and
that's
it's
rapping.
Going number one so far.
That's rapping, though.
That's Black Men Can't Cheat. Stuff. That's Yo, that, I wish you could see him.
Whatever he's saying on that, John, that ain't no singing. He not trying to sing on that.
Yo, I wish you could see my man. Do it again. Do it again. Let's, one, get back into, let's get back in this morning mix, man. We got the assassins in the building. Let's go.
Now you wanna say what's up to me? Okay, so now you wanna make love to me? Girl, if you don't get the f- from me, I know you thought we had something special, but you don't mean nothing to me. Girl, I'm sorry you not the one for me. Just be honest, girl, what you want me? This ain't nothing new, keep it so 100. I can't get one up on me. I go back, I tell you, you better run from me. Give hope to my niggas, this love money. Adios to the bitch, can't get a hug from me. I'm high on life, that's what it does for me. My number's going.
What you wanna woo? It's that woo woo.
You now rocking with the assassin.
Up the strip, folks in my whip and they don't like hanging out all windows, hanging out all windows. Gas break dip, up the strip, folks in my whip and they don't like hanging out all windows, hanging out all windows.
All about a check,
all about a check,
going up the set.
So, Alex, you got to talk to Lil Me about this one, man. You keep dropping this new music on me. I'm like, you got to talk to me. So, what's this one all about? Because I got a little bop to it. You know what I'm saying? DJ D Ready was over there bopping to it. What's this one about?
Nah, this is the Kamaya, Quavo, and Tyga joint.
Where it come from? Like, how Quavo get on the West Coast? That's what DJ D Ready was just talking about.
I mean, I think everybody just wanting on anything, man. For real.
Why?
He got the sauce, man.
Quavo got the sauce? I thought it was, what was his name? Takeoff. I thought Takeoff had the sauce.
Takeoff got sauce, too. I think, you know, Offset. It's really Quavo on Offset, honestly. Yeah. He goes all pop, but Takeoff
is the one that actually can rap, right? Yeah, that's the one that actually got bars. You actually got to think about what he's talking about. The rest of them, they not saying too much. Not even a little bit. But what you were saying about the West Coast, though?
No, I was just saying I think Quavo, he's thriving off the wave right now. Like, I guess it's just the trendy thing right now with the West Coast vibe. I think that's coming back to the forefront. These type of bounces, the Bay Area bounce. So a lot of artists is, you know, putting their style on these type of songs.
Is that why he's hanging out with Musta a little bit more?
Maybe giving him some discounted beats. I don't know.
He's making them YG beats for him. Is that what it is?
Yeah.
And what's this called, Alex?
Windows.
All right, let's turn it back up. Let's get back in this morning. Make shout out to my guy, DJ Alex Flang. Let's go.
And I got that.
We got that new music, man. Reviveisalive.com.
Them hills on the strip. Yeah. I could take a square. Put her in a mix, and I got the best flow, sex instrumental. I'ma make it wet, swim in and hit a breaststroke. All about the pesto, green and financials. And I'm with Kamaya in the town, I'm a desto. Gas, break, dip, shake, arm, leg,
face.
I had feelings before they put stars in the race. I done had that bitch up cool,
keep
on, yeah.
Put that thing on me. Let these other know you came with it.
know. I'ma keep it real cause they ain't gon' be. They play the show in love but they hatin' on me. Yeah, go ahead with your cute ass. Whatever man messed up is a dumb girl. Let me make it right girl, you deserve that. Sundresses make your boy wanna grab that. Yeah, push that thing on me. Keep it so classy but I know you free.
You know I'm rockin' rockin'
rockin'. And pull up in the style on me. Let's go. Push that thing on me. Unit low with the booty, sit the thing on me. Don't do it for the merch, shake that thing for me. Girl, you look good, put that thing on me.
He got like a ton of albums, but I mean, as far as song, content.
Don't do it in the merch, shake that thing for me. Girl, you look.
Let me ask y'all this, right? Speaking of new music, once again, shout out to Trey Songz, you know, straight out the DMV area. But let me ask you this, right? So Drake just dropped two new songs right after, you know, the Raptors win. Everybody knew that he was going to drop some content. He was going to give us something for the summer. But I wasn't really feeling it, you know what I mean? I want to ask y'all, was y'all feeling this new music? Was y'all feeling, especially the one with Rick Ross? We wasn't ready for, you know, a real urban track. I wanted a party anthem. I wanted something that we could dance to this summer. You know, Drake normally gives us around this time, he gives us a summer anthem, you know what I mean? I don't think he's ever gonna top One Dance. I think that 2017 summer is gonna be a wrap forever. But he ain't give us nothing right now. He gave us Kiki last summer, you know what I'm saying? But then he gonna drop this Rick Ross track. I wasn't really feeling it.
I think he coming with it. He always give you like a little sneak peek first. Yeah, he give you a teaser, but he gonna come with something.
So y'all throwing this in y'all mix? Y'all like those two songs?
I love the beat.
Well, yeah, the first one was Money in the Grave. That was the one.
I love that beat.
But I mean, it was like a real raw kind of a track. Like, I want to talk my sugar honey iced tea. Not like, I want to get y'all moving. I want to get y'all pumped up for 2019 summer.
That low key got like a harder West Coast bounce to it. So I got to listen to it again. I'm pretty sure that was like a kind of West Coast bounce.
I feel like he could have came harder. You know what I'm saying?
I think
Kawhi and the boys just wrapped up the Raptors, you know what I'm saying, finals. And you should have came a little harder for that.
Right. I think you never know what type of Drake. Well, I guess it depends on Drake's move, you know what I'm saying? So if he want to give you that bars, Drake, and straight to the point, he's going to give you the bars, give you that real hard, you know, that hard move, not the whole thing. You ain't worried about the hit factor, because he know he can pull out a hit at any moment, you know what I'm saying? He know he got it on, he know he can do that, to be honest. So, I mean, it's like, it's the setup for, you know, I'm sure he's going to have some type of summer smash, or if not, he's going to hit us right in the fall if he's slack on something.
So what do you think about even the combination of that Drake and Rick Ross? I mean, this is not their first time, you know, on the same track together, but what do you think about that combination that Drake and Rick Ross? Do you think that should have been the first one?
Anything with Ross, I'm biased. This is my favorite rapper.
Wow. Ross, not, I mean, as far as, like, he does have lyrical content because he can spit.
And he's one of the best beat
Picker?
Yeah,
that's because he got people like DJ Khaled on his side that can like physically help him in his, you know, selection of music.
I think Ross is just because he's grown. I think he's just
because he's grown.
his maturity with the
it's an elegance to the sound. Yeah. Like, I feel like he can do the raw traps type stuff, but then it's always like it's almost like a luxury sound. I feel like when you associate Ross, he gonna speak some luxury. It's luxury rap.
But now his lifestyle is different. You know what I'm saying? He can't talk about being the head honcho with the stomach at the table. You know what I'm saying? Being a big guy, like, that's not even him no more.
That's 95% of rappers.
No, but I'm saying his content has to switch up. Like, he's in a whole different organic, healthy, holistic lifestyle. Like,
he's still luxury. I mean, because he always fly.
I mean, of course, that's Rick Ross, you know what I'm saying? Tiptoeing on marble floors.
Hey, so I'm biased, so anything you say, I'm going to go against you.
Because Ross, because it's Rick Ross. All right, but let me put this out there, too, because this did happen yesterday. So I'm in Toronto because we were talking about Drake and everything that happened with the Raptors. So according to TMZ yesterday, the crowd actually began to scatter. Why? Because it was reported shootings. So according to TMZ, the crowd began to run after fear of hearing sounds of four gunshots. The incident occurred about 15 minutes, according to 4 o'clock. Around 4 o'clock, Toronto Police Operator Center put out a statement saying shooting. But reports came out that there was no shooting and, you know, everybody should have remained calm during everything that was going on. But they did end up finishing the parade. But this is something that did happen yesterday going down in the parade in Toronto. And it also made me think back about what happened here at the Roots Picnic, you know, in Philly a couple weeks ago. And it's like, when you get in large crowds like that, you know what I mean, the anxiety of people just waiting for something to to pop off, it's already there, right? Exactly. But then when something really happens, it's like, oh shit. But when something fake happens, it's like, damn, what do you believe now? Like, you can't even believe your peers, you can't believe the media, you can't believe the news. It's like, how do you even know how to move out here nowadays? Like, picture over what, 200,000 people in one area, somebody say gun, come on, bro. Like, that's like 2,000 people hurt because you playing around. Like, do you even want business, especially y'all, like y'all DJs, y'all gotta be in concert spaces like that. Like, how do y'all feel about being in spaces, you know what I mean, where anything can happen?
This is really hard to prevent it. If what you're doing, you gotta be in a place. You just gotta, just keep your eyes open, man. It's really hard to prevent it. I don't see how you can, like, stop that. Yeah. All them people, it's like, it's hard to stop that.
Right, yeah, I don't think it's no real way you can safeguard. Most you could do is just really be aware of your surroundings and be cautious. And just keep your eyes peeled for everything, you know. Like I said, be wary of your surroundings because you can't really safeguard anything. Anything can happen literally anywhere. Sometimes it just seems like, I don't want to say cliche, but it just seems like, you know, that would have never happened there, or this would have never happened in there, you know what I'm saying? So it's just like, you can't really...
Because this is even out the country. Like, this technically didn't even happen in the United States, because Canada's a whole nother country. Correct. So, you know what I'm saying? It's definitely happening everywhere. And just the idea of being in that space of over 200,000 people, it's just like, that's a lot of goddamn people.
That's a lot of people.
That's a lot of people. You know what I'm saying? And for people to have that much control over those amount of people in spaces at any given time, and all you got to do is say one word, it's just a reflection of where we are. You know, how big the influence of different things can really take over the minds of people.
That's
and
true.
It's like, of course, we can't avoid it, but it's like, do they start to dumb down these actual events, like where they only start to allow a certain amount of people in? Like, for example, Made in America, you know, it's here in Philly every year, and that physically takes over the entire city, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. But anything can happen to grandma who's just living on Broad Street, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
So it's like, how do you, like you said, it's hard to prevent it, but it's like, you have to find ways to prevent it, because we're getting populated at this time, and mega concerts is the thing. Like, nobody want to just go to a concert where you can see one people. Like, we want to go somewhere where we can see 5 to 10 artists at one time, so that's going to bring out 200 or more thousand people. So it's like,
something like a concert maybe is easier because you gotta pay for it, so they can put about a certain amount of stuff or tickets or whatever.
That makes sense.
Like a parade, that's free, so anybody can come. I could have went
for real. So. I got the waters.
Right?
No doubt, man. But let's get back in this mix. We want to hear from y'all too, man. Hit us up, Revive_POC, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. How can they find y'all, guys?
Find us on the Assassins on Instagram, @Assassins_. Find me, DJ I'll Explain.
And you can find me, D-Ready, that's D_R3, D-D-Y.
Let's get it, man. Each and every Tuesday, each and every Thursday, catch the Assassins live here on Revive. Get back in this Good Morning Mix. I'll Explain, DJ D-Ready.
I'm on some news, ready to the head, man, we're getting harder. Shorty, if I don't ask, don't even call back. Ring.
And I can see why the people hate me. Pull up in the drop and I watch 80. Pull up to the front and you know I'm faded. Got a new crib and
came from the bottom, watching ball up. Drink it to the head, smoke till you fall up. Counting up this money, keep it dough up. All my getting to this money, no lie.
Got a good thing going with a bad chick. You know where to call when you need it. Wish I had another, you don't greet it. Sometimes I let the freak get greedy. Goddamn, I fell in love with a bad chick, bad chick, bad chick, bad chick, bad chick. Bad chick.
trying to stay focused. You must think I got to be joking when I say, I don't think I can't wait. I just need it now. Let it swing my way. I just need some. I just need some love. Tired of f***ing with these lines. Baby, I just need a thug. Won't you be my plug, ayy? You could be the one, ayy. Can start with a handshake, baby. I'ma need more than a hug. Girls can't never say they want it. Girls can't never say yeah. Girls can't never say they need it. Girls can't never say nah. Girls can't never say they want it. Girls can't never say yeah. Girls can't never say they need it. Girls can't never say nah. Oh nah. Give it to me like you need it, baby. Want you to hear me screaming every breathing. I don't need a reason, baby. I want it till you can't buy. I can get it to you right, baby. Oh, I wanna be a healing. I can be real good. Please don't get any feelings. Hey, I need some love. Hey, I need some love. I need some love, ay, and you can't judge.
Freddie, why are you playing this? I'ma just started talking about we need some love.
I thought
everybody was off that City Girls. You know what I'm saying? I thought we was on our love thing right now. We was trying, you know what I'm saying, be faithful in our singleness. Okay. Right?
Black man no cheat.
Black man no cheat.
Woke up this morning, 3 missed calls from my best friend. Ain't want a thing from me, just calling to check in. Just wanna tell you that you're special, but you know it, yeah. Oh. I walked to the corner store with a dollar in my hand. Got everything I needed, got a thing, Ms. Pam. You're such a diamond, girl, keep shining. Anything that you need, I'm here. Yes, my kind of people, the ones that say, hey, how was up, nice to meet you. The ones that don't need you, they just wanna see you. Living the life and still treat you like an equal. If you cool, then we cool. Yeah, that's my kind of people. Drink the other day. This perfect stranger who didn't even know my name. We talked for hours when I found out he was homeless and his home was burned down. Gave every dime I had, but I knew that I wanted more. Given the circumstance, you would think I'm the lucky one. But he changed my life that day when he said, you can burn a house.
Now,
yes, my kind of people.
You need me at the
line now. If you find time, you can run on.
Talk about some things we can undo.
You just in the pen, I can find you.
6-1 on the money, 9-2. You just said a word and I'll come through. You text, no reply, that's what I know.
I know. I'm on the purge, I beat the church. I kill some niggas and I walk away from it.
Yep.
Then I observe just how you curve. Then told the niggas that they gotta wait for me.
I know you ain't hot to man. I'm ballin' on the block in your suit like you want a man. I'm drowning all inside the police like I never swam. Hey, fuck your IG, I put something on your sonogram. On the man.
Me at the London. If you find time, we can run one. Talk about some things we can undo.
You just in the pen, I can find you. 6-1 on the money, 9-2. You just said a word and I run through. Text, no reply, that's when I knew.
Talk, church talk, I can make a brick walk. Up north, down south, Bankhead to Rachel walk. Hit it with a little water, stretch it like a vocal cord. STD, I ran my ward, off Confed and his daughter. I'm a renting compound, I supply the cigarettes and bread. I got a man and she gon' ride. She took a quarter and she fled. I'm in the land, so she gon' ride. I see the pain and shot it like brass. I'm at the London with some big thighs, no fries. She your mama tell you when something on fire, stop driving road.
So I'm not gonna lie, he's whining the entire time. Like, he's whining. Like, my man ain't say nothing. Like, he sounded like his mother just took his lollipop out his mouth and he was plotting on that lollipop the whole time in church. Nah, hell no. This song right here, I was like, if J. Cole didn't come save the day, it would be nothing to listen to. Like, J. Cole had to come snatch this one away from him. Like, why the hell is, like, Doug just out there whining like that? Nah, come on, DJ D Ready. Like, if J. Cole ain't come save the day, I promise you this song will be trash. J. Cole saved the day, like, nah. And I love some Young Thug, but this one right here, bruh, come on. He sound like he in church and he ain't no more peppermint. Like, nah.
Damn, a lot of niggas unchanged on me. Damn, that it changed on me. If I can, I got Jackson, Granny, Ben Frank on me. I don't know why niggas hate on me. I gotta move differently, I got a case on me. I got them hiring private investigators on me. Sitting right outside the crib trying to stake on me. Hold up, wait on it. That's a Porsche caving. Hold up, watch me pull it out the hood stable. I remember when we couldn't afford cable. That's when I knew I had to put in more labor. This trying to take me out my vibe, dog. God tell her I'm alive, dog. Still I'm on my way to the top, dog. Shout out Punch, I say over a shot and K Dot, dog. We doing our regular. Like Hendrix said, we don't do regular. I'm a beast, I'm a predator. I kill like Merc and Slay, etc. I cop any gun and kill for my daughter. I go Rambo for real for my daughter. 2015, I made 2 mil for my daughter. Now he trying to steal for my daughter. What the f? Post trap talk, getting back to it. No good, this ain't no trap music. Soul rhythm blues with a slap to it. Watch how Young Pen Griffey put his back to it. What a niggas on, man, they trippin'. They want me to put them on, that's my mission. Niggas in a rush, niggas don't listen. I'm still tryna get mine, ass sitting down.
You were tryna get it when you were tryna run it through the ceiling when you. Blue colors in your pocket, lean in your kidney. Whenever on your master, ain't no f***ing limits. All the foreigns came new, ain't no f***ing limit. Play with me, I have a massacre in every city. I might drive to D.C. and f*** with Meek Millie. Take a note, I want a chicken fillin'. Take a bitch, I want a
And I wouldn't lie, DJ D-Ready, like, he actually has a sound. That's one reason why I like Thug, because he created his own sound, he created his own wave. But that whining ass shit,
shake it, then taste it.
Say that for the baby. Hey,
we got plenty bucks, order what you want. Yeah, I'm a cash cow, I'm just cashing. I think they put a camera in my pool, but it's on the inside. Goddamn, 12 nasty. I used to be like Jay-Z and ride fat. Till I found out that you gotta put on Davis. They scoping out my house from my cabin. I got the window and start laughing. The inside of my spot carry water. They should change the street, name it Cactus. I'm the same thugger that'll order 10 rooms in your town and no sleeping at them bitches. We just f***ing toxic and freaky on them bitches. So mad that they can't leave none of these bitches. She so bad, sometimes I want her features. All the shit you do, oh, like peoples, all the shit you do, oh, I see you. Even all these crips don't wanna be you.
Oh, yeah. Still trying to get mine. They scheming on me, they still trying to get mine. Oh, they still trying to get mine. Oh.
New YBN Cordae.
Yeah. I know myself far too well to be a stranger of pain. Despite it all, we
remaining the same. I'm just changing the game. Heart pure, never tainted with fame. Straight ahead, I'ma stay in my lane. Never switching courses, life's amazing. It's gorgeous, looking at the bigger picture portrait, and I smile wide. Performed a song and the crowd cried. How can I lie? I'm tearing up as I'm starting to stare in y'all lies. I know that you going through the last month. You stressing as you hitting on that glass blunt. Praying to get lucky like Daft Punk. You can't even stomach the pain. Now that's a bad lunch. Ramen noodles on the regular. Add some seasoning and some hot sauce for a better touch. Peanut butter, jelly, and syrup sandwich, etc. And we just flying in the nebula. And it might not be such a bad idea if I never went home again. See, it might not be such a bad idea if I never went home again. Don't you cry, little baby, it'll be alright. Don't you cry, little baby, it's gonna be alright. I done been around the world 4 times looking for parking. Finally found a condo that still feel like apartment. Out south, my foul mouth started sounding like Cartman. Roundabout like cartwheels, hopped inside of a U-Haul, confused where all my art went. Monsters in a quiet place. Some of these decisions is like Sharpie on a dry erase. I know they thought I wouldn't, but I'm fireplace. I had my cake and ate it too, that is in a quiet taste. I promised I would buy a place. I got my favorite roommates. They used to never see me like when you zip up a new babe. Do that before it's too late. Don't ever drink the Kool-Aid. Don't ever think it's sweet. That's that from De La Poulet. Who do they
believe? Perfect in every kind of way. But I don't think I can handle her pain. So messed up and I'm too busy just running my game.
Now I'm rocking with you.
I try to change my day. Always around pulling me down. Broken condoms, lipstick marks, and unprotected sex. Yeah. Oh. I feel like noise. Sorry, won't turn back to club. Maybe I took revenge cause I knew you.
Got her legs wrapped around my waist. Conversating, she lick every tattoo that's on my face. Like a thug, I just wanna flaunt. That's every day. Temporary separation.
Shout out my guy DJ Alex Flay.
She packed the bags and left me home and I'm still.
He had to play that wrong.
But she can't tell me that it's real first. A lot of lies, apologize, the thirst real. When she hit us, thinking to herself, damn, this verse real. Rehab out in Vegas, that made us some murder set. Sent the bottles to her table, then made love on the jet. Temporary thrills, all these women you think I toss.
Shout out to our special guest who just walked in the building, man. He a big boss himself. My guy Russell's in the building. Let's get it. Each and every morning, man, Revive is alive.
D, my G, he throwing that peace.
Shout out to the assassins, man. Let's get in this morning mix.
I'm just
click, click, click. Ain't nobody fresher than my mama. Click, 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 click. As I look around, they don't do it like my click, 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 click. And all these bad, bad men, they want the, they want the B.I.G. Oh God. I tell a bad bitch, do whatever I say. My block behind me like I'm coming out the driveway. It's grind day from Friday.
Let's go, DJ D ready.
I've been up straight for 9 days. I need a spy day. Spy. Yeah.
She try and give me that Wu-Tang. I might let my crew bang. My crew deeper than Wu-Tang. I'm rolling with her. Girl, you know my crew name. You know 2 Chainz.
Every Tuesday, every Thursday, let's go.
Feeling many million when I'm walking in the building. Freaky women I be feeling. From the bank accounts I'm feeling. What a feeling. Aw, oh, man, it gotta feel. Young player from the D that's killing everything that he see but him. Go. Click, 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 click.
You already know what that means. That means turn your radios up, switch your dials over, cause Revive is alive. It's about that time. It's Meet Your Girl POC. Tune in, let's go.
Welcome to Revive. It's about that time. Welcome to Revive. It's about that time.
All I need is one mic.
You know what time it is. Open up your ears. You know what time it is. Open up your mind. It's about that time.
About that time.
It's your girl POC. Hey. It's your girl POC. Hey. Proof of consciousness. Proof of consciousness.
POC.
You know what time it is. Open up your ears. You know what time it is. Open up your mind.
Yep, yep, to the yep, yep. You already know what time it is, man. It's Meet Your Girl, POC, host of Revive Radio, man. We are back live on Revive is Alive, Revive is Alive, reviveisalive.com. You got to get up anyway, so why not get up with Meet Your Girl, POC, man, each and every morning, starting at 7 a.m., getting this good morning mix. You already know each and every Tuesday, each and every Thursdays, you can catch your guys, the Assassin, live on Revive. Yo, DJ Alex Blaine, what's good? How you feeling?
Good. What's going on?
I'm good, man. Now I know that you in love with Rick Ross. You know what I'm saying? Now I know we're going to be getting that South, that Florida music.
Always,
you know what I'm saying?
Man.
From time to time. And DJ D Ready, how you feeling?
Feeling real good. Waking up, you know, getting this, you know, get the crust out of my eyes.
You got to get the crust out your eyes, man. Tell the people once again how they can find y'all, how they can stay locked.
D Ready. You can find me D_R3DDY.
You can find me DJ Alex Plain, DJ Alex Plain.
Let's get it, man. Let's get it. Support who supports you. Definitely support them. Book them. The summer just got started. They need to be on y'all calendars. They need to be on y'all flyers. Let the people know where you can find them, man. Reviveisalive.com. Definitely find your way to our YouTube channel right now. Subscribe to that YouTube channel. And don't forget to subscribe to that newsletter so you can stay locked with everything we got going on here at Revive Radio. But you already know we got a special guest in the building. Normally he here on Mondays, but I had to bring him out on a Tuesday. You know what I'm saying? It's never too late to get this information. He always brings the knowledge in the gyms every time he come through. I got my guy Russell Dinks in the building. Yo, Russell, how you feeling this morning?
I'm great.
Man, I'm excited to have you back on the mic. It's been a minute.
Yeah.
The people was missing you. You know what I'm saying? They was like, yo, where that money talk go? I'm like, yo, it's coming. It's coming. He had to go handle his business, but he's coming back. How was your, you know, your, I would say your winter. How was the winter for you? How did that wrap up for you?
It was all right. I mean, you know, try to stay fiscally sound, you know.
How was the first 6 months? You know what I'm saying? Did you save some money so you could teach us how to save some money?
Save some money?
You save some money in the first 6 months?
Well, you either save some money or you reinvest. So I took the second route. I reinvested.
Awesome. You want to talk a little bit about that?
I want to get to the first 3 questions. I'm talking about first. I'll go to me personally later.
All right, but tell the people what you do too, because I was telling them about, you know, how you handle the CDLs and different things like that, so the people know exactly who they listen to.
Right, right. So what I do is I actually provide opportunities for people who are college bound, non-college bound, people looking for a second career, people coming home from incarceration. That's looking to get into the professional driving career. You go to ineedacdl.com or you go to ineedacdl Instagram or Facebook and connect with me, and we'll see what we could do to get an application in, see if we get some funding for your classes.
Definitely.
And then move on to some job placement.
No doubt, no doubt. And I'm representing Cheney University right now because that's where it all goes down at. So shout out to CU, my alma mater, man. Appreciate that.
Absolutely.
No doubt. So we got to support black colleges and definitely save black colleges by putting our money back into them.
Mm-hmm.
And that's one way that we can reinvest too. Reinvest into these HBCUs for real.
Right.
And then speaking of HBCUs, let's also just talk about one thing that I wanted to ask you, which came up, was opportunity zones. a lot of us as millennials were looking to, you know, start to get into real estate. We're looking to get into property investments. We want to actually branch out and find a separate stream of income other than just our 9-to-5 or, you know, just, you know, our regular stocks and bonds. So we want to figure out how we can make money while we're asleep. So a lot of people are asking, like, yo, what's the opportunity zone, especially with real estate being one of the highest professions in the city of Philadelphia? If you could talk a little bit about what an opportunity zone is, that would be dope.
Well, basically, you have several pockets in the city in which they're giving you incentives, tax breaks, and other monies to revitalize the area, to come in with different businesses or different opportunities to improve the area and, I guess, combat urban blight. And there are some pros and cons to opportunity zone situations. Obviously, if you're actually trying to get into a business, it's a great leg up for you. It's also if you actually bring in social services to a community that could benefit from there and jobs, then that's a great asset. But there are also some downsides. Sometimes people use the opportunity zone monies and set aside to further gentrification. They bring in businesses that do not serve that community. They bring in businesses that is designed for a different demographic, and then they change the complexion of that neighborhood, and then you find people that are moving out. So you know, you have to. It's a responsibility to getting into that arena of opportunity zones, empowerment zones, and things of that nature.
Definitely. And one thing that I'm learning is that opportunity zones were added to tax codes by Tax Cuts and Job Acts in December of 2017. So pretty much what it is doing is helping people to get tax cuts as well when they're doing their real estate.
Absolutely.
Because of the different tax codes that they put on it when it comes down to these zoning.
Right. Right. Absolutely. So again, It's a double-edged sword. It could be a great thing if it's used as it was intended. It could be otherwise if people abuse it.
Facts. So when it comes down to opportunity zone, how does one, like, I don't know if you say, how does one get into these zones, or how does one become a part of the zoning? You know what I mean? Like,
right. So every neighborhood that has empowerment zones and it has the local CDC, I would start there, go to them, talk to them. And they usually have a finger on the pulse of the monies that could become drip down as a result of improving the neighborhood.
Yeah, so one thing also is that it hasn't even been around for long. This is something that actually just came out last year. If I could just drop a statistic on you, the first set of opportunity zones covering parts of 18 states were designed in April of 2018. Opportunity zones have now been designated covering parts of all 50 states, including the District of Columbia and 5 U.S. Territories. So this is now something that started last April, so almost, well, it is a year old now. So something that is a year old that just started to allow people in those zoning areas who are pretty much taking up pretty much of the urban cities to take over what's going on.
Right.
So when it comes down to the people who want to buy low, you know what I mean, and then revive the house or revive the property and then turn it into whether it's a real estate property or whether it's a brick and mortar, you know what I mean? How can they get involved? Like, how can someone who is buying low get involved?
Well, again, that's something that it's a combination of things. The economic side of it will be through the CDC. Strategy is as far as buying low and getting it on the ground floor, then you should actually get align yourself with a great real estate professional. My professional of choice with that is Charisma Harper. And if you guys are interested in linking up with Charisma, just go to, again, connect with me on Facebook or Instagram, and I'll go ahead and connect the dots with you. But she'll be able to navigate that for you.
So also through my reading, right, one of the questions was, what is a qualified opportunity fund? So pretty much like a qualified opportunity fund that allows you to get into, you know, one of these opportunity zones. And it was saying that a qualified opportunity fund is an investment vehicle that sets up as either a partnership or a corporation for investing in eligible property that is located in qualified opportunity zones. So when it comes to the fundings, like we were talking about, you know, prior to, this was a couple months ago, now that I think about it, we were talking about, you know, sole proprietorships, LLCs, corporations, and different things like that. So it's saying that it would either set it up as a partnership or a corporation. So going into one of these opportunity zones,
can you recommend, or what would you recommend as far as if it should be a partnership or if you should go in it as a corporation, as a big business?
Well, when you start businesses, you need a couple of different components. You need your legal component. You need your monetary component, and also you need your taxation component to it. So I would basically, because every one of these different corporations is set up based upon individuals' visions and their structure and their mindset of how they want to run their business. So I would sit down with a tax professional, an accountant that I would trust, mm-hmm. and I would actually give them the vision, and they will be able to navigate which way you should go with that. Mm-hmm. There's no right or wrong. There's lots of different options there. So it just goes down to what the flavor of the person is that's trying to start the business.
I would recommend, like, one thing that I'm finding out is actually working for others is simply that going into it like a co-op, you know, whether mm-hmm. I have 5,000, you have 7,000, right. Now we have 12,000, right. We can actually put this down payment down instead of sitting here waiting so I have a full 12 stocks to do that. You know what I'm saying?
Well, as we talked about in the previous discussions, if you go into a partnership or any type of situation where there's multiple people, you should plan your exit strategy at the same time you're planning the inception of your business, because things could go different, it can go left. Mm-hmm. You can decide that you want to mature out that relationship, so you should have already having your mind how do you get divorced before you get married.
No, and I love that answer, trust me. I that was one of the tips that stuck with me, trust me. And one thing, because you were talking about taxes, on the website too, it actually asks that question. It says, do I need to live in an opportunity zone in order to take advantage of the tax benefits? And the answer is actually no. You do not have to live in the area in order to take advantage of the benefits. You can take advantage of the tax benefits even if you don't live, work, or have a business in the opportunity zone. All you need to do is invest and recognize gain in a qualified opportunity fund zone and elect or defer a tax, and it will be granted to you.
Well, there lies the danger that we talked about. Right now in Philadelphia, you have a lot of people who are preying on Philadelphia from other states, namely New York City. They're coming, the big developers are coming here, they're buying up a lot of property, they're taking advantage of the tax credits, and they're actually doing interchanging that community. Now, if someone could argue whether they're changing for the better or to the detriment of the people who live there, mm-hmm. but you know, time will tell.
So, what do you think about that? You know, just as you being a resident of Philadelphia and you actually seeing, you know, people coming from out of state, buying up property, buying up the real estate, buying up the blocks and different things like that, actually making it look like New York City for real, if you think about it, look like a little bit of New York mixed with D.C., in my opinion. So, when you see things like that by you being a resident, what are your thoughts?
Okay, well, there's a couple different things you can do. If you want to stay in your property, you can prepare, because you know that the tax system is going to go through the roof and you have to figure out whether you're going to be able to afford to stay there. Or you can strategically decide, you know, what's the valuation of this property and at what point in time do I need to sell and sell for the highest value possible in that situation. Or you could actually start to invest in the property that you're in and whatever, so that you could, even when that real estate market gets to the top, that you excel, you sell or refinance or whatever you have to do at that particular point. It's based upon education and strategy. Mm-hmm. To bury your head in the sand and not do nothing is where they actually raise the taxation. Now you can't afford your taxes. Now you're displaced. Or somebody comes up and puts $100,000 in your face and you jump at that. But 2 years later, you know that property, now that property's worth $500,000 or more.
Facts.
So you have to be educated in your situation.
And make
a decision on what you're going to do.
And let me ask you two of these questions. I'm going to get the DJs in real quick. DJ D-Ready, I explain, when it comes down, because I'm a renter, do you guys rent right now currently?
No.
Okay. Damn, I need to ask y'all that. So let me ask you. Let me ask my damn self. So when it comes down to being a renter, right, I'm learning that I'm actually spending more in my rent than I would ever do in a mortgage. You know right. what I'm saying? Even like my rent in a whole year is a down payment on a house.
Exactly. Exactly.
So talk to me, Russ. Like, how do I get out of this? Like,
how do you get out?
How
of
do
that?
I stop renting and become a homeowner without having the initial, like, down payment money? Because it took me a year to get that money.
Well, we have to borrow out of the playbook of other races that live around us. Sometimes you have to, we are taught, especially in our community, that you're 18 years old, 19 years old, get out on your own, have your own, and so forth. In other situations, they're taught to, okay, let's sit here and incubate for a minute,
save our monies, and then we'll go out and buy something as opposed to getting into the renting treadmill. Mm-hmm. So once you're on that treadmill and you're paying rent and you're paying utilities and you're paying for a quality of life, it's almost impossible to save money in a reasonable amount of time.
Yes.
To go and do so, unless you're actually running way below your means. If you're actually renting in some situation that's $400 or $500 a month, you may be able to do that. But you may have to suck it up and say, okay, we're going to go ahead and cohabitate with two or three of my peers for maybe 12 to 18 months and then make a move.
So you're saying
a sacrifice on the front end for the benefit on the back.
That's big. You always, man, telling me stuff I don't want to hear. I didn't want to hear that part. Like, you know what I'm saying? And the thing about it is I do see that happening with other cultures. You know what I mean? Like, they're actually migrating together, and then eventually they end up having 4 to 5 homes and 3 businesses.
The case in point is a lot of the Chinese food stores on the corner.
Yes.
They've been there 50, 40, 50 years. They're not the same family. That's a churn business. Mm-hmm. One family comes in, makes their bones, leaves out. The next family comes in and make their bones, and mm-hmm. so forth and so on. You know, so it's just a leg up.
So you gotta be willing to sacrifice. It's pretty much what
absolutely
you gotta be willing to sacrifice, man. Shout out to my guy Russell, my hand in the building. We just was finished wrapping up about opportunity zones. If you want to find more information about that, you can go to the irs.gov. It is going to give you more information about that across the entire 50 states, so you can learn more information about opportunity zones and how you too can benefit from it, and also how you can be a part of it, especially if you are interested in real estate or if you're interested in just finding a different way of streaming your income, and if you want to get off your 9 to 5. So my next topic that I wanted to bring up too was the 1031 exchange.
1031 exchanges, yes, right. Yes. So basically the 1031 exchanges in simplest forms, explanation of it is, all right, say you have an investment property, let's say in Germantown, and that investment property you want to go ahead and sell. Well, if you sell that property outright and you want to pocket the money, then you're going to have a 20% capital gains tax on that because it's income coming from an investment property.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if you take that property and you sell it, but then you invest in 2 or 3 other properties with those monies, then you could avoid the capital, you could defer the capital gains tax until the time that you actually sell or liquidate those other 3 properties.
All right, Russ, can we back up just a little bit? Because I want to know a little bit more about this myself. So the 1031 is something that helps you when it comes to exchanging investment property. So it has to be an investment property. It can't be a property that you are currently living in.
Right. So that's you're doing it because of the investment strategy situation. Okay. You're doing the deferment, just like you defer your student loan.
Okay.
I'm not going to pay on this 20% now. I'm going to pay for it at a future time.
Okay.
But in the meantime, I'm going to maximize my leverage point by being able to buy more investment properties or more investments now, and then I'll pay the tax on it later. By doing so, you have now driven down that tax because hopefully the amount of money that you have made over the period of time that you have your other properties and the increase in value of those properties is a sound investment over time. You basically have eliminated that 20%.
The 20% off the initial investment.
Exactly. So you have a property that's you sell for $100,000. That's $20,000 with the tax on that property. So you take the $400 instead of the $80 that you would have had, and you put it into other properties, and then if you flip those properties over the period of time, either in equity or in sale, now you have doubled up on that money or tripled that money. So now when you look at that $20,000, it's no longer $20,000 anymore. Because you have made your money work for you. Now, suppose you keep those other properties that you invested in for 20 years. That means you avoided the capital gains tax on that other property for 20 years. Meanwhile, that property has increased the value, and you got rents for 20 years. So
can
that's
you
how you make money.
That? So can you automatically reinvest? Like, do you ever have to physically touch that? Does it have to become tangible to you and then put it back out there? Can you just keep pushing that same 20% out there?
Can you keep pushing this same 20% out there? I imagine that you could. I mean, I haven't seen anything that says that you can't do that. Now, when you actually talk beyond just the the base level explanation. Again, that's when you need to bring your tax professional and give you other strategies how to have tax avoidance. But that's how the people who have money and power stay and have keep their money in the power, because they know the actual ways to navigate through the tax code.
Yes.
And do it legally. Our first thing is, you know, I'm gonna get some property, I'm gonna invest in it, then I'm gonna flip it, and then I'm gonna do this, that, and the other thing, and that may work, but then again, you're subject to that taxation.
Big taxation. So how does someone even get into the 1031? You know, the 1031. Like, how does someone get into that?
Again, you have to go. You have to, when you sit down and set up your business as from the escort LLC, whatever it is, and you have your vision board of how you want to do things, and then when it gets to, okay, what do I do with the money? Then you said you have your attorneys on one side and your accountants on the other, and you figure the processes out. A lot of times, people in businesses, small business or starting out in business, they'll say something like, you know, I know this is true because my uncle says so. And what does your uncle do? Well, my uncle works with SEPTA. Well, is your uncle a lawyer? No. Is your uncle does your uncle the accountant? No. Then, I mean, with all due respect, your uncle may be right in his explanation, but why would you go to a bus driver for a tax question?
Facts.
You know what I mean? It doesn't make any sense to do so. You know, or my cousin has a barbershop, so he knows business, so therefore he's qualified to teach me about my real estate business. I wouldn't go to the cleaners asking them for a sandwich. So why would I, you know what I mean? It's like, you know, go to the person who's the subject matter expert and get the right answers.
So let me ask you this. When it comes down to deferring your loans, like, why would you even want to put a loan on deferment? Or why would you want to put an investment on deferment too? Because it does.
Because you're not taking money out of your pocket today. Anything that you could pay later is better. It's always better. If you could pay, you could pay something later, especially while you're growing money. So, you know, I mean, it just that's the reason why, okay, when you look at when the city puts a moratorium on taxes for developers, mm-hmm. and say that you can't pay, that, okay, it's a 10-year moratorium. That means that they could develop, and don't have to be responsible for 10 years from now. Would you rather pay, today or 10 years from now? Yes.
But at the end of the day, that does nothing for the 10, to talk about the 10-year in tax and payment, that does nothing but put the people of the city of Philadelphia in jeopardy.
Right.
Because we won't be able to own anything. It will be all bought up, and the people who have ownership over those things are not even paying on them, but we're still paying taxes every day for the properties they're not even paying property taxes on.
Right.
But, so that becomes the argument. Yeah, but tax abatement only works for business owners. It doesn't work for the people.
Right, well, that's part of the machine. But you're not either you're going to get in line with the machine or you're going to fight against it. It's, you know, you only have two choices.
So what are we supposed to do?
Get in the game.
What are we supposed to do?
The machine is not going to stop. I mean, when has ever the machine stopped? The machine doesn't stop.
But come on, though. Like,
I mean, you know, the thing about it is, all right, you know.
That's that Donald Trump business.
Off topic for a second. When it comes down to things that are detrimental to us, as far as, like, you take things like alcohol, tobacco, gambling, whatever other vices is so well marketed and propagandized that it seems almost benign to us. Anything that's good for us, like the tree huggers and eating properly and the vegan movement and things like that, people who belong to these common sense causes think, well, it's common sense. Why wouldn't somebody do it? But you don't have the marketing muscle behind your agenda to make a difference. That's the reason why things never change. Because they actually they know what they have is a detriment, but they have to package it like it's okay. You say, okay, why would you want trees? They provide oxygen for the earth. That makes sense, but do you have a $6 billion marketing plan for that? No, because you think, well, why wouldn't we want that? Doesn't everybody want a tree? But if I put a $6 billion marketing plan and said, no, we don't need a tree, we need an apartment building. We need actually to more parking lots. We need all kinds of other things. You're going to lose.
Facts.
It doesn't matter what your common sense argument is. This is not what it works. That's not what I work here. Money drives everything. In this case, money drives marketing. Marketing drives perception. Perception is reality. So your common sense arguments are toilet tissue.
Money drives marketing. Marketing drives perception. And perception drives reality.
Right.
But at the end of the day, how does that... That is actually a great quote. I love that.
make sure you patent that one. But when it comes down to
you can have it.
When it comes down to, you know what I'm saying, just business though, you right. know what I mean, like that gets you reported to the Better Business Bureau, because I'm the type that's going to call.
Right.
That's not good business.
And don't you realize where's the funding for Better Business Bureau come from? The actual businesses that are rated by the Better Business Bureau.
Big facts.
Right. So you don't have any coins in the Better Business Bureau, so why do they care about your complaint?
Because I still got to make my complaint. That's like calling 311 on the city.
Everything's following the money trail.
I call 311 on the city too, right. man.
And you have the city policing itself. How does that work?
But you still got to make, but you got to hold these businesses accountable. I do understand that.
You only hold people accountable once there's consequence. Your parents hold you accountable because if you don't do what they want you to do, then you get a punishment. You either get some sort of corporal punishment or whatever the situation, but there's a consequence. You can't hold people accountable without consequence. And so they don't really care if you march, if you complain or whatever. That's going to last about 2 weeks. And then you got to go back to your regular life and the machine's going to roll. Mm-hmm. There's no consequence. It was a long time ago, like back in the 1700s and stuff like that, where the government and everything, the thing like that, was afraid of the people. People would storm up, would storm City Hall and start shaking people by the collar and all that type of stuff. Now people are afraid of the government. So therefore, there's nothing that happens. So that's just the way it is. So bottom line, get in the bed with the machine and roll with the machine. Or get rolled over by.
Or you can find a different stream of income, which is this, you know, 1031. Okay. So once again, Russ, tell the people why they should get involved in the 1031 exchange.
You should get involved with the 1031 exchange to defer your taxation out as long as possible, thereby making money in the meantime and hopefully eradicating that deficit. Mm-hmm. And one of the things that you said that you asked me about that I wanted to touch on, you said, how do you save money during the summer of 2019?
That was the next subject. All gotcha.
Right. So one of the things a couple of things that you need to do, you need to realize that we live in a great geographic area. We have Maryland, we have DC, we got New Jersey bordering us, and Delaware bordering us. So what you could do is there's a lot of free events that go on during the summer. So what you need to do is start partaking in the free events as much as you can, and maybe do maybe on Friday, Saturday, I'm gonna do two free events, and maybe on a Sunday or whatever day you prefer, I'm gonna do something that you actually have to pay for. So let's say you go to a book signing or some other thing, some other bazaar, fair, whatever it is, outdoor concert that's free or whatever it is, and then you jump on a boat bus and you go up to New York and you have lunch up in New York on a Sunday or whatever it is. So you have done something all 3 days. You was outside the house and you were able to still not spend a lot of money. Mm-hmm. You may be able to decide that a couple of friends may want to, every weekend over the summer, somebody may host something at their house or whatever. You know, might bring something, you guys hang out, you know, whatever, play, have game night, game day, whatever the case is, doesn't cost a lot of money. You have to stay away from things that you have to buy stuff to get ready for. It's going to be, we're going to this event, so I have to go ahead and buy this new thing and buy this and buy that and get my hair done or go buy whatever. All that stuff costs you money for a couple hours. You only have it for a couple hours and then it's over with. So it's a zero-sum game.
Stay away from events so you have to buy stuff to prepare
right.
for.
Right. So then the other thing about it is that one of the things that you need to do is just tell if you're trying to save money, especially for a house, car, whatever it is, just put it out there on your social media or tell your friends, listen, you guys will have to give me a year. Give me a year. Whereas though I can't really go to your birthday parties. I can't go ahead and spend money on your graduation. I can't do this or other thing. It's not that I don't love you, but give me a year. Mm-hmm. I've been your friend all these years. You give me a year. Whereas though I can just be myself. And just so there's a bonus, don't buy me anything. Don't buy me nothing for a year, and I won't buy any of you guys nothing for a year. And watch how your money will grow. Especially if you're women, because women actually have to go ahead and do a whole lot of prep to go to every event that they go to. It's a lot of money that you spend in the course of a year. You don't even realize it.
That we asking our men for.
And even that, you know what I mean? That costs tension, you know, because he's not invested in your girlfriend's party, you know, or your girl trip. And that's the other thing. You don't always have to go away to be away. You want to go to the beach? Go down to Rehoboth. You want to go to the beach? Go down to the thing down in Maryland. What's it
Ocean
called?
Ocean City.
Ocean City or whatever it is. You can spend a day or whatever down there and come back. You don't have to get hotels and do the whole thing or whatever. You know what I mean? If you go down there, you could drink, you could have a good time, you get a great nap on the beach. Nothing's like sleeping on the beach. That beach sleep is crazy. You get up, come back, or get an Airbnb or whatever. But you don't have to spend a lot of money to have a lot of fun.
Facts.
You know.
Don't do the things that you gotta pay money to prepare for. I actually like that. Right. All summer 19. Let me ask you guys this question though. You know what I'm saying? Summer 19 is coming, and one of the topics that I brought up with Russell was pretty much, you know, how can we save money going into summer 19, and then also while we're in summer 19, like how can we save money? And as you just heard what he said, but what kind of ideas do you have? How are you going to do it? Let me ask you that. How are you personally going to save money?
I mean, I think he gave great advice. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I'll probably have to take some of his tips on how to save money and, you know, just not putting out more than you're taking in. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's pretty much simple and plain what I could think about it. You know what I'm saying? Just keep your...
What about for the gigs that you got to pay to get there for?
I mean, that's just gas. I guess I don't know. I guess in my mindset, too, sometimes with certain money, you're putting it out regardless, I guess, but that's what I look at it as. I gotta take the bus or I gotta drive my car. So I mean, maybe the bus is more convenient. Maybe the, you know,
well, that's business.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Is different.
Right.
Is different. Exactly. You get money back.
Yeah, exactly.
Going to a birthday party, you just put money out.
Right. Exactly. You're right. Facts.
Yeah, you could have drank the eight at home if you wanted to.
Right.
And what about you, Alex Lane? What about you? How you saving money 2017, 2019? I'm tripping.
I like the idea of hosting more stuff at your own crib so you ain't got to go nowhere.
Right.
That's cool with me. I do that all day.
Right. Yeah.
So, I mean, having stuff like that, yeah. And like you said, I know with our gig stuff, just pocketing more stuff like that. Like with gas and stuff, we charge more. So, like, we make it more. So, we ain't got to spend that much.
That's one thing that I learned too. I actually started to put transportation in my fees.
Right,
like
right.
That costs money. And I don't drive, I Uber everywhere. So it's like, you really want me there, you got to pay for the Uber. And I'm not saying it like that to be disrespectful, but it's part of the game, honestly. Yeah.
He's supposed to put it in there. It's supposed to be seamless. I mean, the number is supposed to be the number. And you know that pays the Uber.
Yeah,
you know
that pays the... Yeah.
But when you start carving it out, people's like, well, why should I have to pay this?
And, right.
You know, you don't even give them that conversation. This is the number.
Yep.
And you gotta know your worth. Mm-hmm. You gotta know your worth. Yep. They don't need to have. I mean, when you actually go, think about it. When you go to Walmart and you buy something out of Walmart, they don't say, okay, well, this is the price because then we had to truck it in from here and then we had to put it on a plane from there. You don't really care about that. What's the number?
Right.
What's the number?
Right.
That's all it is. You know, when you start to try to be too transparent in that, now you give them room for negotiation.
So you're saying don't be that open when you're talking about
numbers. It's not necessary. Where else in business do you see where, you know, they say that when you actually go buy something, they give you an itemization of, okay, this is what we pay the insurance, the lawyer, the marketing, this is how the packaging persons or whatever. They don't tell you that. This is the number.
But Russell, let me ask you this, because one thing that I'm learning in business is that there's a difference between a business and an entrepreneur, right? So as entrepreneurs, you talk different numbers than you would talk when you're talking a business, right? Because you're selling just yourself. You're not selling necessarily a product.
I thoroughly disagree. You are a product. You are the item that you're actually speaking of. So therefore, when you say this is the all right. So we're having two conversations. All right. So one entrepreneur says to the prospective buyer, okay, it costs. Okay, the event is this. You want me from here to there? The event is this distance away. Gotcha. All right. I could do it for $500. And that's, you know, and that's actually looking at it. I think that's a fair price. You have the other guy that comes in and says, okay, well, it's $300. What did I charge? Then I charge $50 to get there, another $75 for this, and that's it. And they might get up to $500, but one guy seems like he's nickel and diming, and the other guy seems like he just has a price.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And that's what you run into when you start doing that.
Right.
It seems like you're trying to, okay,
persuade them.
Yeah, because you're $300. That's what they want to pay because that's what you said your service was.
Yeah.
Now you're adding on. Anytime somebody adds on, even when you go to cell phone companies, they say, okay, well, it's only your bill's only going to be $29 a month. But then we have to add this and taxes.
Facts,
this, every that starts to make you angry. You
right,
have done
right.
that list. You know what I mean? So why even make people get people in that mode?
Mm-hmm.
You know what the distance is, okay, where it's going to be. You do your own calculation. Okay, that's the state of it. Hold on one second. Let me do this statement. Let me work up an invoice.
$500.
So just pretty much give them, and I love that. So pretty much give them the number and
right.
So if they even ask for a breakdown, you still.
Well, if you think that they're going to give, listen. If you think that they're the type of person, because some people, you could tell somebody it's 50 cents and they want to go ahead and argue you down for 35 cents. That's the way they built. So you could say, listen, it's $650, but because you know this is my period, my slow period, or whatever, or that I got an opening window, or some whatever your excuse is, I'll give it to you $500. $500 could be your number already. Right. So you already told me $650. $650 discounted the $500. If they say they want to go lower than that $500, now they're being disrespectful. Because mm-hmm. you already said what it is. Mm-hmm. And then you just look at them and say, you want more than $150 discount? That's why I just asked them. You want more than $100? Well, I'm just saying, can you work with me? No, you can work by yourself.
Yeah, that's no, we need him on the money team with us, man. I'm trying to tell you. We got to come correct. We got to say it aggressively. You know what I'm saying? And that's the thing I would definitely, and that's why I appreciate you the most, Russell, is because a lot of millennials that you're speaking to right now, we're trying to learn the game that you already have as far as sealing deals, making sure we're getting contracts signed, making sure these invoices are coming, making sure the deposits are even there before we show up to the event. Because a lot of us are showing up to the events mm-hmm. without the deposits being made.
Right.
So we want to make sure that we're handling our business the right way. And I appreciate mm-hmm. you for always coming through. But we're about to wrap it up. But I want you to introduce your guest who's with you right now, too, while she's in the building.
This is my good friend, Monica Moonlight.
What's up, Monica? How you feeling?
What's up?
What's up, sis? Go ahead and introduce yourself. Let the people know who they listening to.
I'm Monica Moonlight. What else I got to say? What you want?
You got a business, what you do, why you with Russell right now, you know what I'm saying?
Russell is my mentor at the moment.
You got a great mentor.
A beginning entrepreneur. I have a mixology and hookah rental service.
Awesome.
You know, for private events here and around the city and the areas.
Awesome. Yeah. So you're based out of Philadelphia?
Yes.
How can people find you?
You can find me on Instagram.
You got to talk to the mic for me.
Oh, sorry.
No, you're fine.
You can find me on Instagram. Let me remember what my Instagram name. I'm sorry. It's Mocha Ayaba, which is chocolate goddess in Yoruba.
Awesome.
So, yeah, just type in Mocha, M-O-C-H-A, period, Ayaba, A-Y-A-B-A, on Instagram.
Tell me a little bit about hookah, the hookah business, because I see that really taking over and becoming like one of the biggest things as far as entertainment. Like, you can't even go into a bar if they don't, like, a lot of people won't go into the bar unless the bar has hookah nowadays.
I work at a bar. People come in all the time and be like, you guys got hookah?
Don't even drink. They just want the hookah.
They just want the hookah.
Yes.
Because hookah is now a thing where, like, it's seen as better, you know, than smoking and... it's something you can share with your friends, and a lot of times you'll have like urban music playing. So like, I lived in DC for a year.
And that's where I'm from.
Oh really?
Yeah.
What part, girl?
Southwest, Southeast.
So, oh, that's where I live. Yeah. Anacostia, boo.
Yeah, it's an open MLK.
And you know, Adams Morgan. That's mm-hmm. one of the biggest parts of the city for college kids and the millennials. Mm-hmm. And what do? Smoke hookah. And they stand in line mm-hmm. for hours. And that's the thing about hookah, you know, it is a generational thing for millennials.
So do you gotta go get a license to smoke?
No, you actually don't.
Okay.
I have what would I call him? I guess I would call him a colleague who, he has 99 hookahs in the city.
Wow.
99, he just...
When you say 99 hookahs, you mean actual
like
hookah?
Physical hookahs that he goes to different bars and different lounges, and he pays them $75 a week to allow him to have his hookahs in there, and he profits everything else.
Smart business.
Like, completely and utterly smart.
Smart business.
And he said, since I've done it, I haven't worked a 9-to-5 since. And he's been doing it for like 3 years, I think.
It's going to take over. All right.
It's wonderful.
So, Mocha, we're going to see how we can actually, collaborate and get some things popping. I don't smoke hookah, but I do know a lot of people who do, and I do definitely have a lot of events where we can put that in the
I have mixology, I have DJs.
Oh, we're going to do that because we like brunch and we like mimosas in the morning. Oh, so, I was already plotting on that one. As soon as you said that, I love me a little mimosa. I ain't gonna
I'm your bartender.
Yes, let's get into it, man. I appreciate
you. I actually have other bartenders. That's my thing. That's why he's my mentor, because I'm in the business of making money and helping other people my age make money. I'm 22.
Awesome.
So, like, I'm in school, you know, it's hard out here.
Mm-hmm.
You gotta do what you gotta do. You gotta get out on your grind. And if we can make money together, Why not?
Big facts. What school do you go to right now?
I go to University of Maryland.
Actually. Awesome. That's big. Shout out to UMD.
Shout out to UMD Terps. What's up, yo?
Yes, yes, man. I appreciate you for coming through. Russell, once again, hop on the mic. Tell the people how they can find you, how they can stay locked. He will be coming back on Mondays, guys. Money Talk Mondays, each and every Monday, live on Revive, man. If you got some questions, definitely send it my way so I can get them prepared for when he comes back on Monday. Send them our way right now, revive.poc@gmail.com or revive_POC Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
Yeah, you catch me at www.idcdl.com. Just go there, take a look at it, fill out an application, or send me some comments, whatever you want to do. And in light of what Monica was saying, teaching her and teaching others, the way you make money is when you're not present at that time.
Mm-hmm. That's big facts. Big facts, Russ. We got to get you on the gram or something, man. These people want to see your face more often. They want to ask you questions online. We got to get you on the gram.
All right.
Come on, Russell. Come on.
All right.
Please.
All right, we'll do that.
Well, you got me.
We'll connect the dots.
All right, help me. And guys, how can they find you too once again before we turn these airways back up?
Yeah, follow us at The Assassins. That's THEASSASSINS _ on Instagram, Twitter. And you can follow me, D Ready, D_R3DDY.
No doubt. What about you, Alex Plain?
You can find me, DJ Alex Plain, DJ Alex PLAIN.
Let's go, man. The Assassins in the building each and every Tuesday, each and every Thursday. We about to get in this mix once again, man. Shout out to my guy, Russell, for coming through. You can catch him live each and every Monday, man. Each and every Monday here live on Revive. We'll be back tomorrow. Tomorrow's Winning Wednesday. So you already know, man, we got a jam-packed show for you guys. Turn your radios up. As you can hear, the Assassins is ready. Let's get into it.
This your boy,
Round,
the mayor of Philadelphia. Need y'all tune in to Revive Radio.
This is Charles Wilson Adams with I Choose Health 215. I encourage you to be a hero by starting a conversation. You are now tuned in with Revive Radio.